Welcome to this Java 8 video. You may have searched for Java 8 features in Google or YouTube or somewhere else, but I promise you that none of them would have explained to you in this way. I'll explain to you in a super easy, friendly way that you would grasp the entire knowledge of Java 8 features just like that. Please do focus on a few minutes of what I'm trying to tell you. And I promise you that you'll get to know by this end of the video what Java 8 features are and how you can privilege, how you can make use of that in your everyday programming life. So Java 8. This is considered to be the best version that is released till date. It is released in March 18, 2014. This is the day it was released. And everyone at that time was so surprised and impressed by this feature of what the Java 8 is giving to the developers. It was a revolutionary release of the Java for software development platform. It also includes various upgrades to the Java programming, JVM tools and libraries. So let's see now Java 8 programming language enhancements. So the first and foremost thing you have to know is functional interface. If you have a book or a pen behind you, beside you, please do take a note of what I'm telling. It may be useful for you in later. The first is in functional interfaces. I'll be talking about three at a time. First is functional interfaces and next is lambda expressions. Sorry for my creepy handwriting. And the third is method references. So I'll be talking about 3, 3, 3 like that. First I'll be talking about these three and then we'll be moving to the next three enhancements. The first one, what is a functional interface? So functional interface is nothing but whenever an interface that contains exactly one abstract method should contain exactly one abstract method. For the meantime, I will erase this. Functional interface is nothing but an interface that contains only one abstract method. Now you can ask me, brother, what you are saying, what is abstract method, what is this interface and why only one abstract method like that. For example, in Java, if you are using Java as your programming language, when we say something is abstract method, is that, for example, if I have an interface here, for example, Sable. This is an interface. Now, pointer, sorry. Now let's say this is an interface, Sable. And inside that we have something called void say. We no need to implement it here, but it's just, no, we will just declare it here and we'll just leave it. This is called abstract method. So functional interfaces are nothing but interfaces with only one abstract method. Like one abstract method. This is an abstract method where we'll just declare it, but we'll not implement it here. We'll implement it later somewhere. So this is called abstract method. And there is one abstract method, right? This is one abstract method. And if I wrote, if I write another abstract method like this, this is second abstract method. Then this is not a functional interface and it will show a compilation error because functional interface should have only one abstract method. I will tell you the use of using only one abstract method in second and third enhancements. But you should only use one abstract method, then only it is called as functional interface. Just you need to remember this. This is enough. So the first point is covered. The first point is functional interfaces, and you now know what are functional interfaces. Functional interfaces are nothing but interfaces with just only one abstract method. And next is lambda expressions. Lambda expressions are nothing but to make use of this functional interfaces more. For example, the lambda expressions are written as argument list body. So this is how a lambda expression is written. To tell you more precise, it would look like something like this. For example, if you're passing no parameter, the no parameter syntax for lambda expressions are this one. Just open and close brackets, an arrow, open the curly brackets, there will be body here. Whatever logic you want to write, you can write here, and you just need to close it. This is how no parameter syntax looks like. No parameter. This is a no parameter syntax, this one. For one parameter syntax, it would look like open p1, parameter 1, arrow, open and close. Here body will be present. So this is a one parameter syntax looks like. And if there are two parameters, simply we need to add comma p2 here. Like that, we can add n number of parameters, and we'll just open the curly bracket and close the curly bracket, and this will be the body here. This is called this is how we use lambda expression. For example, I'll just write a small code here for you to make understand more better, because you'll make use of lambda expressions more and more when you try to use Java 8. We are implementing some anonymous class. For example, take drawable. Drawable is some anonymous class, and here we are declaring D and a new drawable. We are now implementing it. Okay, we'll open this and we'll close this. We'll write some logic here. For example, public void draw, some function we'll write, and we'll close it. Before lambda came into place, we used it to write programming like this. We used to write drawable d, new drawable, open close, open curly brackets, public void methods, and we used to close it. This is how without lambda expression means before Java 8 came, we used it to write like this without lambda. This is without lambda. Now with lambda, how we will do is simply just you need to write drawable is an anonymous class, that's all. It don't take it as something it is important name or something. Some anonymous class we can write here, bike or something. Drawable d2 or d1, I'll take it as d2 here, equal to open. I told you, right, this is lambda expression, arrow mark, open curly bracket. Now we write whatever the logic we want to write before. For example, I want to print something, then we'll write system.printoutln, something will print out, and we'll close it. This is how a lambda expression works. So this makes things much more easier now. That is called lambda expressions. Lambda expressions you will be mostly seeing in JavaScript. But from Java 8, it is implemented in Java 8 also, in Java programming language also. And next is method references. Method references also make use of this something called functional interface, which we have learned in the first one. So method references are nothing but you no need to know a lot of things about that, but you just simply need to understand that Java provides this feature in Java 8, and it is used to refer method of functional interface. It is just used to refer method of functional interface. And you know, this is compact and easy form of lambda expression. Instead of using lambda expression, this is much more compact and easy form. Each time when you are using lambda expression to just referring a method, you can replace our lambda expressions with method reference. So now let's see how to how to do this. We have seen already lambda expressions, but method references are much more better than lambda expressions. So let's have a look at it. Usually there are three types in this method references. One is reference of a static method. The second is reference to an instance method. This is for static, this is for instance. Just know that these are present. Next is reference to a constructor. You need to know this. Like using this method references, we can reference a static method, an instance method, and to a constructor. You need to always remember this, where method references works on static method, instance method, and to a constructor. I'll give you a small example of this method reference. So instead of you using that lambda expression, the syntax for static method, I told you, now we can do it in static method. For static method, that is to reference for static method, the syntax is containing class, keep two dots like this, and static method name, the method name which we want to refer. This is for static method, the syntax for static method. If you want more examples on this, and if you want more coding part, then in the description I'll provide you the links, because I am writing this in whiteboard, I can't write the complete program here, but I'll provide you the links in description, all the codes. For example, if you want to learn about static method and this syntax and how to use in real programming, then in the description there will be a link. You just need to click on it and you'll be moved to that website. There you can find all the examples and all the syntaxes which I'm talking. And the next is instance method. Now in instance method, the syntax would be like containing object. Containing object is nothing but where this containing class is, where the static method name is present. Containing object is nothing but where that method name is present. Where that method is present, instance method. I hope you are understanding. If you are not understanding this, please do refer that code which I'll be provided in the description. Containing class is nothing but in which class the static method name is present. In containing object is nothing but where this instance method is present. That is just simple. And the next thing is reference to a constructor. Reference to a constructor is a bit too simple. It's nothing but for constructor. The syntax looks like class name, where the constructor is there, class name, new, that's all. These are the syntaxes of the method references for the coding, please do see in the description. So now we have covered three topics till now in Java 8 enhancements. One is lambda expressions, we'll come in an order. First one is functional interfaces, second one is lambda expressions, third one is our method references. So till now we have completed our first three. Now we will see the next. The next is fourth one. I'm sorry. Fourth one, which is called Stream API. If you want to take a break, just take a break right now, because first three have learned. Now we'll be talking about 4, 5, 6, that is Stream API, and we'll be talking about default methods. Default methods, and we'll be talking about base64 encode decode. This one is not pretty much be, it will not be needed, but it is good to know. So first three are completed, right? And the next three are Stream API, default methods, and base64 encode and decode. Now we will see that in part 2 video. I'll make a complete part 2 video on Stream API, default methods, and base64 encode and decode. So let's continue in that video.